Relax, it's ASMR. Hello everyone. Today's video, I thought I would pull out something that I've had for a while. A very long while, actually. And I've always meant to do a video with it, but never quite got around to it. And that is these Mikomik toys that you put together. They are very colorful and pretty easy to put together and very durable and great for kids to play with. And we bought these several years ago as potential gifts and kind of forgot about them. So I've been wanting to do a video with these for a while, so I figured today would be a good day to do that. And please excuse my voice if it's a little deeper than normal. I am getting over a little bit of a head cold that I got over the holidays. But I'm feeling much better now. Just my voice now sounds very deep. But maybe that's a good thing. I hope that it's at least somewhat relaxing. So let's get into this and started to put it together. I love these sets. I have one that we got that I put together back when we bought these. And I have it in my office at work. It's a kind of a race car. But this is a train. And you can see each individual piece has its own kind of place in the box. If we pull up this whole plastic thing very carefully, underneath there are the books. So let me do that. I love the boxes. They always have very clear instructions on the outside. You can basically kind of put it together based on what is on the outside of the box. So here is the instructions, I believe. Yeah. Very big and bold. It's not wanting to open up yet. What's going on? Come on. There we go. So on one side you have a listing of all of the different pieces that go together to make the train. And on the other side, you have very basic visual instructions on how to do it. And then this is, well, there's the car that I have in my office right there. This is a catalog of all the different. They have an airplane. It's really cool. Several different airplanes. They have a helicopter. A very large biplane. Some more planes. They have a little forklift. That's neat. Here's the car I have, and I think we gave this car to one of my nephews or nieces. There's a smaller car. Some tractors. It's another race car. Looks like some sort of a delivery truck. It's a tow truck, big one and a small one, another delivery truck, a small dump truck, two types of motorcycles, and there's a big train, and then here's our smaller train. And a sailboat. I'd forgotten about these. So I haven't seen these in stores for a while. Like I said, we bought these many years ago. And I've just been kind of hanging on to them. So this plastic cover is taped down. So let me see if I can gently pull off the tape. See if there's any other. Yep, there's some tape here on this side as well. Oh, that one. Let's go ahead and pull that off. Looks like it's taped on all four sides here. Get my fingers around it. Okay. And then finally, good. Okay. So now, one little piece left. Throw all that away. And we can finally reveal all the pieces. Now, how this works is you have these little pens of different colors. These are red and yellow. Looks like those are the only colors they've got. Oh, we also have some more in here. So these are the pins in here. These must be just for decoration. And you have this little tool. It goes together like that. And it helps you if you need to pull out the pins, you can use that. And you have these little black rubber ties or straps that hold the different pieces together. So I'm going to, it's really hard to get down in here and pull those out. So I'm going to dump just a few into this little container lid. And we can pull them out as we need. Okay. So the first thing we need to do is put one of these pins in like that. And so tight fit. And we can take another pin and kind of put it through there and stretch it around. so that it fits in. It's a tight, springy fit. So it holds them open just a little bit. And you can use this to pull out the pins. And also, I think this little divot here is to push them in, because sometimes it might hurt your fingers and require quite a bit of pressure. And that's basically all that's needed to make everything fit together, because everything else is based on little holes and little pins that go into the holes. So I'm going to turn this box so I can see the instructions. Okay. So we have the base of the train here. And we have some large wheels and rubber that goes on those wheels. So there's four of them here. And then we have the hub that just snaps inside of the wheel, like that. So there's one. There's two. And four. Now, I believe we have these axles here. Seems to have a flat side. This one has a flat side. This one does not have a flat side. This one has a flat side. Interesting. Okay. So this must be for something else. Maybe for a different set of wheels. Because these have to line up with these holes specifically. So we put the flat side, line it up, should be a tight fit. I'm going to need both hands for this. Okay, let's make sure we got this right. This flat side goes in there like that. Let me push down on the table here. Make sure that's really set in there. We may need to do that again. I'm not sure exactly how tight those are meant to be. We take our other one with a flat side. We do the same thing. Now, those go in like that. And now we can put in the other side. Push them together. Okay. They roll easily. That's good. and they kind of click in place. That's what I thought. Okay. So now we have two smaller wheels. And we have I don't believe those are what we need. We have the river here. If I can grab this, one second. It's slippery. There we go. And then this one here. I can't even get the tweezers down in there. Okay. Very clumsy all of a sudden. There we go. Okay. So these have a little ridge where this rubber snaps over. So that works very well. Tight fit. And then that makes sense because this does not have a flat edge, and this does not have a flat edge. So these can fit in like that. Click in place. And then we have these here that go on the front. Kind of like the bumpers, or maybe the, if it was a car, they'd be the headlights, but I think these are just the bumpers. So now that looks like the picture of the first step. Okay, so now the next step involves these little pieces here. We have one stud that is larger than the other one and fits in here like this, theoretically. Maybe. Get in there. It's a very tight fit. Very tight. Let's try a different one. Maybe there are slight taunt. There we go. Much better. That's how it's supposed to work. Okay, let's try this one again. Shouldn't be this hard. It's like it almost wants to go in, but it's just a little off kilter. Trying to push it in as straight and as I can. It's each individual stud will go in. It's just like the space between them is what's throwing it off. It's like it's just a little too wide. don't want to break anything here. I had the feeling if I had a hammer, I could make this work, but I'm gonna try something here. I can separate this out. That way I can put pressure on this without bending the whole thing. Okay. I'm gonna try banging it on something. There we go. Just need a little bit of persuasion. Off camera. So, let's see if this one has the same problem. I think it did. That's better. Okay. Hooray. So that's why you had to have the flat spot on these axles, so that these things lined up correctly. Okay. So now, these long red pieces. I feel like I need really long fingernails to make this work. These long pieces go here and are attached with these. Sure, I have it right. They show these yellow studs. Hooking everything together. So I just need to rotate this so that it lines up here. And push it in. Same thing on this side. So one is at the top, and then one is at the kind of at the bottom, so they're a little offset from each other. That's really cool. Okay. So now, the next thing are these green ones. Here. In the middle, using these red studs. side. And then they also attach to these, which go on the inside, and also attach with the other red studs. Just like this. The green on the outside and the red one on the inside. Okay. And those will hook up here on this side eventually. The next thing we need is these green pieces here starting to form the body. Making sure I have this right. They go on the inside like that. Fits in like that. Then we take one of these bands and we attach the two pieces together. In the back and in the front. And they're rubbery, so they stretch a little bit, which adds to the tension. That fits there. I don't see if anything particularly holds this on yet. We have this here. It goes over the top. And is strapped on like this. Just line that up there. One more strap here. Okay. So that goes there. And this gets this yellow thing on top of it. Turn it so that it matches the curve. that is the second step completed. Okay, so next steps involve a few things. The first one is the front end here. And that involves this piece here. And this piece here, okay. This is starting to make sense a little bit, okay. So that fits in there tight like that. And then this goes here, so these are redundant, we don't need these. Thank you, pliers. They gave us some stability, but now we need this. So that goes on like that, ensuring that it is on the correct way. This attaches back onto here. Looks like we have a little gap there. Make sure that really sits down in there. We put a strap here. Then we need to turn it around so that it faces up like this. Then we can put a pin in like that. So that is one of the things that holds this whole thing together. So that's good to know. And then we have this, which goes on like that. Okay. That's definitely on there tight. So now it's starting to look like a train, isn't it? These sections here, which fit like this, slide in there. I love the tolerances these are built to. It slides in perfectly. Okay. So first of all, let's strap these together here. Let's get a few more of these out. Okay, that makes sure they're held together there. And then we have two more that come down this way. And they fit in here. And these need to bend like that. This is a tight fit. You've got to put the pin in and then stretch the rubber band a little bit to get it to fit into the hole. Which it doesn't want to do. Let's see here. Let's put this down on the table so I'm not holding it the whole time. I don't know if you can see what I'm doing. It's kind of black on black. Okay, there's one. Exactly. Excuse my fumbling around. I think this was made for smaller fingers of children, not big clumsy fingers of adults. So that's what holds the body onto the frame more securely. And we have a final strap here. And one on this side. Like I said, it's very tight tolerances, but that's what holds. This feels like a very solid toy when you're done putting it all together. Something that's going to last for a long time, for sure. So now we have our final few pieces. And those are these here. These get attached with these straps here. It comes out a few. So we know that we need a strap there. And we need a strap here. Slides back and forth like that. not super clean, but this one in here. Get it to sit down in there. Seems to be catching here. It was obviously made to fit in that groove. There we go. Not quite sure what's going on there. We'll check that out in a little bit. So now, this sits on here like this. And it also gets two straps up inside of here. The inside ones have the strap like that. They have a little bit of rough plastic there. So let's push these around where they need to be. Get them in place. So that pops on like that. Then we'll swing these down into position. It's not quite as tight as the other one, but it's still a little awkward. Sorry if you can't see what I'm doing. Or the grimace that I have on my face when I'm trying to make this work. Come on, you can do it. I believe in you. All you gotta do is catch the very corner of that. You should be able to pop it in. But I'm gonna do it this way, even though you can't see what's going on. Set it in there, now pull down just a little bit. It's easier said than done, isn't it? Mm-hmm. So I got these pieces on finally. My battery died on me, so you probably missed that part, but that's okay. It's just more of me struggling. And the final piece is this little button right here. So I'm gonna move this out of the way. It is now empty. Put that down there. Should line up there. And again, very tight on the tollers. It clicks right in. Okay. We have a nice little train. Little pistons work in and out. That's pretty cool. And again, it feels really solid. Trying to get that to set in there a little bit more. Looks like it wants to fall out. But it's got a nice weight to it. You could give this to a really small child and they could, like maybe, let's see. Let's see what the ages on the box are, shall we? This says ages 6 plus. But I guess that's because you have some of these small parts. Because I imagine a little baby's teeth would be able to just, you know, get a hold of that and pull one of those out if it needed to. So that's probably why they have the age on it that they do. But as far as indestructibility, they could throw this across the room and it would probably be just fine. So I always enjoy putting these together. They're not as complex as Legos, but in many ways they're challenging because they only give you the visual directions. They don't give you step by step by step. It's just this chunk, and then that chunk, and then that chunk, and then that chunk, and that's it. Plus a little bit on how to pull out and push in the little nubs using the pliers. And they always give you plenty of extra little bands and nubs. It all can fit right in there. Well, I hope you've enjoyed this video. Thank you for watching. And please subscribe to my channel if you haven't. I'll be making more and more videos to help you relax and experience ASMR. So I'll see you in my next video, guys. Thanks. Bye.